Good morning, students. For example, what is meant by percentage? Percent. Here only the definition is the percent. Per. So particularly about one. Cent means 100. Percent for 100. Per 100. Okay. So for example, the cost, so we are having 1000 rupees. Okay, what is the 10% in 1000? So 10% means for 100, 10 will be the value. 10% means, so out of 100, 10 rupees. Out of 100 rupees, 10% means 10 rupees. Out of 1000, what is 10% means? You have to write 10% means 10/100. 0000 cancel 100. So for 100, 10 rupees, 10% is 10 rupees. For 1000, 100 rupees is 10%. For 10,000, what is 10%? 10/100, then 1000. So this is called 10%. For 100, 10% is 10 rupees. For 1000, 10% is 100 rupees. For 10,000, 10% is 1000 rupees. So like that, percent for 100. So it's called percentage. If you want to do percentage, for example, one number is given x. What is the 5% of x? And just you can multiply x into 5/100. The 5 ones are 5, 5 20s. X into 1, x by 20. This x by 20 is 5% of x. 5% of x. So somebody, if you go to the bank, you are deposited 1 lakh rupees, so they will give 11% interest per year. Okay, yearly they are giving 11% interest. Means, for example, if you fixed deposited in the bank, after 1 year you will get the interest income. How much? 11,000. Okay, for example, the bank will give 11% interest for fixed deposits. So if you deposited 1 lakh, after 1 year you will get 11,000 plus 1 lakh. 1 lakh 11,000 you will get. So like that, if you want to get interest we are gaining, interest we have to pay, that one you have to do like this, using this percentage. So percentage, some shortcuts will be there, very easy. For example, 1000 rupees is there. So generally, 2.5%, 5%, 10%, 50%, 20%, 100%. So here, 10% is the middle value. So for any kind of value, any kind of income, if you want to find 10%, very simple. 1000 rupees is there. What is 10% of 1000? 10%. Just you can strike out last zero, and 10% of 1000 is 100. For example, here last digit zero is not there. 528 will be there. What is 10% of 528 rupees? And just zero is there, can cancel it. Zero is not there, just one digit before you put the decimal. 52 rupees 80 paise. So what is 10% of 528 rupees? 52 rupees 81. Like that, 10% you can find. So what is 10% of 1 lakh? 10,000. So for example, 10% of 1000 is 100. No, for example, if you want to find 5%, here 10% is rupees 100. No, if you want to find 5%, 5 is half of 10. No, here what is half of 100? 50 rupees. If you want to find 2.5%, 2.5%, 2.5 is half of 5, no? So we can find what is on half of 50, 25 rupees. So like that. So for example, 10% is 100, no? If you want to find 20%, it is more than 10, no? So how many times? Two times, okay? So you have to multiply with 2. So if you want to get 20%, 10% value, you have to multiply with 2. 2 into 100, 200. 100% means full. What is 100% of 1000? 1000 only. How? 100/100 cancel. 1000 will be getting. So like that you have to do this percentage. Sure. Now we'll do the sums in exercise 5.1. So the first sum, in this exercise is 5 So here I'll read the question. You can answer that one. Otherwise, I will write first one. Smita works in office for 6 hours and Kajal works for 8 hours in her office. So find the ratio of their working hours. So here Smita working 6 hours in office, Kajal 8 hours. So solution, ratio of working hours, 6 hours is to 8 hours. Cancel, 2 table will go now, 3:4. So the ratio of working hours of Smita and Kajal is 3:4. So like that you have to do this problem. This is first Roman, first sum. We'll see the second Roman, first Roman, second one. We'll see. Second one. One pot contains 8 liters of milk, while other contains 750 milliliters. 8 liters, 750 milliliters. So two parts are there. In one part 8 liters milk is there, in other part 750 ml is there. So first of all, we have to convert whatever the values are given in different units, liters, milliliters. So both we have to convert into minimum units. So liters, milliliters, which is minimum? Milliliters. So here liters you have to convert into milliliters. You know, 1 liter equal to how many milliliters? 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliters. So 8 liters equal to 8 into 1000, 8000 milliliters. This is first part. Second part of already we have 750 ml now. Ratio of milk is equal to, first you have to write 8000 ml is to 750 ml. Okay, here and here you must get the same units, otherwise you don't get the correct ratio value. So 0 cancel, 5 table will go, 5 ones 5 6 0, here 5 ones 5 fives. Okay, okay, again 5 will go, 5 threes 15, 5 twos 5 threes. So that is 32:3. So what is the ratio of quantity of milk in two parts is 32:3. 32:3. So this is second sum in first Roman. Now you'll see the third sum in first Roman. Speed of a cycle is 150 kilometer per hour, and speed of scooter is 30 kilometer per hour. Okay, so you have to find the ratio. Ratio of speeds. Here both are in kilometer per hour, kilometer per hour. So both are in same units, so no need to change. Directly you can take the values. 150 is to 30. 0 cancel. Now 3 table. 3 5s are, 3 1s are. So 5:1. So what is the what is the ratio of speeds of cycle and scooter is 5:1. So like that you have to do this ratios. 7:2 quantities are given. How to do that one? Just you can see like that, and you'll see the second sum. Second sum. If the compound ratio of 5:8 and 3:7 is 45:x. Find x. This kind of problems already you did in 7th class, I think. First you have to find the compound ratio of these two ratios. Then you should equate that value to the 45:x. So first of all, compound ratio of 5:8 and 3:7. When you are doing compound ratio, just to keep the comma only. So then you can write like this and like this. 5 × 3 = 15. 8 × 7 = 56. If any table is cancelled, you cancel it. Otherwise, you can leave it. So now this compound ratio is equal to this one. 15:56 = 45. Because it is this compound ratio is equal to this one, no? So that's why we have to equate. So when two ratios are equating, then you should do product of extremes equal to product of means. 15 × x, 15x, and this into this, don't multiply. Just you can write like that. This 15 transpose that side. Here it is multiplying. If you transpose that side, it is dividing by 15 three times. So x equal to 168. So what is the value of x here? 168. Okay. So like that, you have to do this problem, and you can see the third sum. Third Roman. If the compound ratio of this sum, you should do same model in second sum model only homework. X is 5.1. Third sum you should do very easy only. How to do in second sum same model only, that third sum also. Now you see the fourth one. So fourth one also same like that. You should do, but here something differently given. I will explain. The compound ratio of 3:4 and the inverse ratio of 4:5 is 45:x. Find x. Here this is somewhat different. You have to find the compound ratio of 3:4 and the inverse ratio of this one. Okay. So compound ratio of 3:4 into directly you can write comma. Inverse ratio of this one. What is inverse of this one? Inverse ratio means you have to interchange the values. First value into second, second into first. What is inverse ratio of 4:5? 5:4. Now you should do the compound ratio. Product of antecedents into product of consequence. For 3 × 5 = 15 and 4 × 4 = 16. Now this compound ratio you should equate to this one. Then you find you can get x value. So now 15:16 = 45:x. Now whenever two ratios are using is equal to symbol, product of extremes equal to product of means. 15 × x, 15x, 16 × 45. Here this 15 transpose that side, 16 × 45 / 15. Three times x equal to 48. So what is the value of x here? 48. Okay. Like that we have to do this problem. So remaining problems, they are writing problems. So we have to do somewhat some statements you have to write, and have to do that sums. So remaining problems we will discuss in the next class. You have to do the homework third sum. So today you have to complete in classwork 5.1 exercise 1, 2, 3, 4 sums. Okay students, thank you.